shape for the future generations. Like this twisted coffin made of paper that turned from this to that with the help of the two-dimensional and three-dimensional reconstruction of the city. I also did city for many stored mummies and objects at the basement of the Egyptian Museum that helped in their conservation, indexing, and promoted some to be exhibited, like this one. I did the city scan of the coffin, and inside the coffin there was a mummy of a 15-year-old boy through playing with the settings. This is the 3D. If I remove the coffin, and this is the mummy with so many jewelry. In fact, there were 36 of them. And I even was able to identify each one, do reconstruction, and do 3D printing. So an amulet inside the chest of the mummy, you can hold it in your hand. And this is some of the copies. This can be used in exhibitions. They can be touched by visually impaired visitors, and this would support the museum and the tourism, which is the future of Egypt and the present. In addition to my work in the museum, I also use portable x-ray and go inside the tombs, maybe here in 30 meters underground, in order to x-ray mummies to avoid the damage that may happen to them by transportation. In addition, I was invited in 2017 to give a 90-minute talk about my work, but instead I chose to present a mini course to teach radiologists to introduce the paleoradiology to the RSNA, and I was re-invited in 2018. In addition to teaching paleoradiology to the radiologists, I also give lectures to the public in order to know about our heritage and how we did to save it. And my book, actually, it was awarded that of the best popular science book by the American publishers in 2017. This is my experience from Egypt as a paleoradiologist to enter the past to see the future. Thank you.